bad guy. Duh.
What's going on, everybody? My name is Taylor, and in today's video, I feel like complaining a little bit, so buckle up. It's gonna be a bumpy ride. People are awful. I'm gonna start off with that. People are awful. I was walking through Albertsons the other day, and someone decided they didn't want their frozen turkey anymore. And instead of putting it back or telling any of the people that work there, hey, I don't want this anymore, would you mind putting it back? Which in that case, I don't think any working there would be like, I don't want that. They'd be like, yeah, no, I got you, I'll put that back. But this individual decided that he was going to stuff his turkey behind some Fruit Loops. And unexpected me walks up, takes the box of Fruit Loops, and sees this frozen turkey behind it. Except when I came across it, it was no longer frozen, so it was just a puddle of blood, and it's gross. They're just gonna have to burn the whole store down. It's start from scratch. No coming back from that. No, but like, why? Why would you do that? And I'm sure it was, like, hidden behind there. So it wasn't like anyone else saw it and just didn't say anything. Like, no, just no one had seen it. And you would think someone would smell that. Because, like, as soon as I saw it, it was like, oh, yeah, that's why the entire aisle smells like death. That makes sense. I figured Tony over there with the name tag and everything just didn't wear deodorant today. That's what I was thinking. I don't know. Anywho, yeah. A little public service announcement. So if you see something like that, just say something. Tell one of the cashiers. Tell anybody. Please. Being someone that has been on both sides, seeing things that are out of place, and also being someone that worked there and had to clean those things up, I can tell you 100%, we appreciate it when people tell us things are broken, out of place. You know what I hate? I hate rude people. The transitions, these stories are gonna be spot on. I hope you appreciate all these spot on transitions. Anywho, I hate rude people. For example, once upon a time, back when I was cashier, not a made-up story, it's an actual story, I was a cashier, and this lady was going through my line. She was on the phone, right, going through the check stand, which is extremely rude, I know. I mean, if we're going to be honest, as a cashier, I could tell you, we don't care. We could care less if you're on your phone. You could be on two phone calls, you know, at the same time. We could care less. As long as you aren't screaming on the phone. Because if you're talking too loud that a person in the back of the store could hear you, we got a problem. Two, if you can multitask and be on the phone, we're Gucci. As long as you don't hold the line, we're Gucci. And this lady in particular did those things. You know, she was chilling. She wasn't screaming on the phone. She was able to multitask. You know, I didn't have to, like, wave her receipt in her face. You know, she took it instantly. It was good. She paid really fast. She pulled the line. Again, she wasn't screaming on the phone. She was chilling. I was chilling. Everybody's chilling, right? Mm-mm. The lady behind her in line, not. The lady behind her in line was having a bad day. Something, but she was just like, I'm gonna tell this lady off. She just starts screaming at the lady on the phone. And she was like, you're being so rude, it's so disrespectful, blah 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 blah. You're being so mean to this cashier. I was just like, And the crazy part is, she didn't even think, like, in her head, she was like, yeah, tell her off. But everyone else was like, oh god. Okay, children, no one look at the crazy lady. No one make eye contact. And she will leave us alone. But, like, the lady on the phone wasn't being rude. But you're being rude. Then my advice to you people, just worry about yourself, you know? I don't know. It's not difficult. It's not rocket science. You know? I also hate when people cut in front of other people in the grocery store line. Like, why are y'all in such a hurry? And I'm a really passive person, so when people cut in front of me when I'm checking out, I'm just like, yeah, whatever. I don't like when people give me excuses on why they cut in front of me. I'm like, nah, you're rude. Bye. But, I mean, obviously, I don't say that. I'm like, nah, yeah, you're good, dude. Oh, you're in a hurry because you gotta go to work? Nah, I feel you. A message to all the people that bring their dogs in the store. Appreciate you. Shout out to you people. You were always the highlight of any day that I worked. The people who don't like when dogs are in the store, go away. No one likes you. We're not in the majority. Actually, you might be, but still, no one likes you. Go away. I never understood that. Like, why do people have such a problem with dogs being in the store? Like, I don't know if you know this, but all of the products are sealed. No, crazy. Also, and like, okay, I know like the produce isn't like sealed. I mean, some of it is, but some of it's like, you know, like bananas are just loose, open. What if dog hair gets on? I don't know. Wash your produce before you eat it. You know, I know that's a crazy idea, but idea out there. At the store that I worked at, there was a lot of crazy times. You know, a lot of crazy people. There was this one guy who came in and bought a pack of gum, right? And gave me a dollar. It was 99 cents, so you know. And the piece of gum, the dollar, put in the thing, got the penny, gave him the penny, gave him the receipt, told him he saved a dollar or whatever. This dude looked at me, gray faced, and was like, "Where's my change?" And I was like, "Penny? You're holding the penny right there, you know?" And he was like, "No, I paid with a 20. Where's my change?" And I had to think for a minute. I was like, hold up, did he pay with a 20? I think so. I'm like, I'm pretty sure he paid a dollar. It was pretty early in the morning, so I was kind of like, did I get enough sleep last night? Did I forget? He actually gave me a 20? I was like, thinking. I was like, I don't think so. Right? I don't. But eventually, we came to a stalemate where basically, he was not going to leave. He was dead set that was his 20. He'd give me a 20 and like he was gonna leave with change. Luckily the boss came over and was like, "Here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna count the till, you know, and if it's over the amount that you say it should be, give you that money back and we'll give you a nice little gift card as an apology." As soon as we were like, "We're gonna prove it," he was like, "Ah, never mind." Which I was like, "Huh, weird. You don't want us to prove it? That's weird." He was like, "Yeah, man, forget you guys. Just take this piece of gum back. Take this pack of gum back and give me my dollar back. I'm never coming in here again." blah, 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 blah. Now, crazy part is, he came back 5 days later and tried it again. Now, if you were wondering, my tale was spot on that day that he came in and accused me of stealing from him. Did not steal from him. Crazy. Now, he tried it again. I know what you're thinking. Well, Taylor, hopefully he tried with a different cashier, right? He might have had better luck. Yeah, he might have, you know? If he had tried it with some of the other cashiers, they might have actually been like, huh, yeah, I must have. Here's your change, you know? Because I almost did that. I almost was like, huh. Because sometimes all the customers just kind of blend together in a day. So if one person randomly says, oh, no, you gave me the wrong change, I'm like, I did? Okay, whatever. What'd you say? What are you saying you need? Okay. You need the whole till? Yeah, take it. You know? But I was pretty good. I was pretty spot on with change. At least I thought I was. My till was always good. Anywho, the dude came back 5 days later and tried it again. Now, I didn't recognize him because I completely forgot about that scenario. But when he said those words, hey man, you forgot my change, it instantly clicked and I was like, oh yeah, you were the crazy guy from last week. And I didn't even waste time talking and like arguing with him. I was just like, we can count the till right now and like prove it. And he was like, never mind. I was like, that's what I thought. Bye-bye. You know what I also hate? I hate when parents aren't watching their kids. Because when parents aren't watching their kids and kids are just able to roam wherever they want, bad things happen. Things happen? Yeah, bad things happen. This is what happens. Turkeys get left behind, Fruit Loops, you know? We've all been in that grocery store where the baby is crying and the mom is just shopping, not paying attention, not trying to like soothe the baby. Like, yeah, baby's crying and it was whatever. It's not whatever. Please calm your baby. Do something, you know? Leave the store. I don't know. I feel like I could complain about stopping and you guys' stories all day. But I think I'm gonna end it here. I'll probably make a part two. You know? Because I like complaining. Complaining is fun. If you don't complain once in a while, try it. You should try. Anywho, if you're new here, be sure to hit that subscribe button and the bell icon. You're notified of when I upload. If you're unsure of when I upload every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday. I know. Crazy. 3 days a week. A whole lot of videos. 3 videos a week. Yeah. Anywho, that's it for today's video. See you guys next time. Peace out. I might just text you, turn your phone over, when it's all over, no settling down, my text go to your screen, you know better than that.